way, Mom.
Be right down, Cliff. Okay, Joe, we're finished. Al, hit it, okay. What's that?
How much on these 16-penny nails?
16-penny? Oh, I don't know. I'll have to look it up.
A magazine cutter would only cost $4 to make.
For a piece of wood to go under the mattress? No.
You gotta have a number.
Pete, what's the price of the 16-penny nails?
$10.50.
Got that, any?
Sir, I would like to paint this. Is this board all right for blue?
Well, that's the best board we have for blue.
Thank you.
Whee!
Oh, I almost forgot. What? Beauty shop delivered your wig.
Oh, good.
Well, Miss McClure, your sister's in the office.
She is.
Couldn't matter myself personally. Yes, sir. You count on me, sir. Yes, sir. Hi.
Oh, Chuck.
Hold the line, please.
Chuck, did you take care of that Martin deal yet?
Yes, Miss McClure.
Watch it, Tiger.
Oh, spoil sport.
Hey, listen, we got a problem.
Oh, you gotta have a number.
Well, the fella I lined up to be your dinner partner tonight canceled out.
Fine.
So we gotta find you a man for tonight.
No, we don't gotta find me a man for tonight, Maxine. It's a business dinner, and I could care less.
Oh, I must know someone.
Well, of course I know someone. I know a lot of people, but I'm really not interested. Maxine, when are you gonna stop trying to find me a husband?
As soon as you give me some of that whatever. Ow! Oh, come on. Just because I'm dieting.
You can have one cup of weak tea.
Oh?
No sugar.
Well, we're gonna find you a man here.
Look, Max, I love you dearly, and I appreciate your interest in my welfare, but will you cool it for tonight?
I just don't happen to think that it's right you're being
without a dinner partner. I don't need a dinner partner, Maxine. I don't need a man in my life. I'm doing just fine. I really am. Boy, I have a business to run. I have three beautiful kids to keep me company. What more do I want? I'm doing just fine. Will you relax?
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, will you cool it, please?
I like it this way.
Devoting her life to her family.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Baloney, that's what's wrong.
Baloney?
Listen, already your kids have a better deal than you do. At least they go to bed with a teddy bear at night.
Oh, I knew you'd get to the bedroom sooner or later, you little devil.
On a cold night.
I turn on the electric blanket, okay?
Well, I do better with a nudge.
Oh, Max, I feel sorry for Harry.
Oh, he does all right.
Look, let's be realistic.
Mm-hmm.
Suppose I was interested. Can I tell you what's available?
What?
Confirmed middle-aged bachelors and divorcees.
Divorcees? I don't think you call a man who's been
I don't know
divorced
what you call them, but they're all after you know what.
Ooh.
Losers and factory rejects.
Well, there's always Mr. Wright.
What if Mr. Wright is out there? How do I compete with the 20-year-olds?
Well, like they say, if you're number two, you have to try a little harder.
Oh, is that what they say?
Yes, that's what they say. Well, back to work. Evans William.
That's William Evans, and he's a plumber. Will you get out of that index? That's private. You're not going to find anyone in there anyway, Maxine.
Mm-hmm. Ingram.
Electrician.
Ingalls.
Insurance.
Iverson.
Is that Jake Iverson?
Jake Iverson. Well, what does he do?
He's just a friend.
Attractive?
Yes, Max, very.
Well?
He's just someone Phil and I used to know, dear.
Oh.
Flip, come to the office right away, please.
Abby, it says here Jake and Evelyn.
That's right. That's his wife. Or was. He's in the same boat I am. Flip, office!
A widower.
Yeah, Mom. I'm just leaving.
Already? Holy smoke, it's late. Honey, pass these out before you go, would you please?
Okay.
Thanks.
Bye.
See you.
So long, Aunt Max.
Bye, dear.
Yeah?
Mr. Iverson, just a moment, please. Mrs. McClure calling.
I'm not kidding at all. Come on, sit down and talk to this nice man.
Maxine.
Come on, talk to him.
I can't ask him. I haven't seen him in years. Just ask the man to dinner.
Miss McClure, I...
Oh, Mrs. McClure, I'll talk to you later. I don't even know what to say.
Hello.
Hello? Jake?
What'd you say it was?
This is, Abby McClure, Jake.
Oh, how are you?
Oh, I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
Fine, fine.
And how's your little girl? Lacey?
Stacy.
Stacy.
Close.
She's fine.
How's your,
The boys. I have three boys. They're fine, thank you. He doesn't even know who I am.
Just ask him.
Abby, Phil's wife.
That's right.
It's been a long time. I meant to call you after Phil,
Oh, I understand.
Will you just ask him?
I'll tell you why I'm calling. It's, I'm having some people in tonight, you know, for a little dinner party, and I thought that, if you weren't doing anything, that maybe you'd like to come.
Dinner tonight?
Yes, uh-huh. You can. You can? Well, that's good.
It's 4248 Myrtle Drive.
And that's, 7:30-ish.
That sounds great. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.
You can't tell me you aren't bored seeing just one pair of shoes under your bed.
Oh, Max, is that all you ever think about? Sex?
Yes.
Hi, neighbor.
Hello, Cleo.
I seem to have misplaced my garden clippers. Got a pair?
Yes, ma'am.
Hate to trouble you, Jake.
I guess your husband's out of town again, huh?
You know George and his hunting trips. I don't see your daughter around.
Oh, she's staying with a friend. Here you are.
Want to help with my garden?
No, Cleo, I think it's real bad luck to go digging around somebody else's garden.
You're scared.
You're damn right I am.
Too bad. Stop by for a drink later?
No, I have to go meet somebody.
It's the wife of an old friend.
I'm the wife of an old friend.
Yeah, yeah, this is different, though.
Don't you like me?
Sure I like you, Cleo.
It's my husband, isn't it?
What do you mean?
I can't get to you because of George.
Well, I like George, too.
Wish I could say that. What a wicked waste. Well... toodaloo. Have fun,
Jake. Yeah, I know. Is the house all straightened? I hate shrimp. Yeah, I know. Is the house all straightened? Yes. Good. Did the boys have their dinner?
You know I'm not the type to complain, but on days like this, I get the feeling that I'm keeping three horses out of work.
Where are they?
The horses?
The boys.
Flip's in his room, and the other two are in there.
Where?
In there.
In the living room?
Yes.
Oh, Molly!
In the living room? Where do you expect? There are no other rooms here except...
What is going on in here? Oh, now you know we have company coming tonight, and look at this room.
But you told me I could paint.
That was 2 months ago when you had the mumps.
I told you, Jason.
Now, you're no better, Mitchell, but you should be. You're older. You just get off of this couch. I've been fat. And you get over here. Now, enough is enough. Now, you two just hop to it, and you get this place cleared up and right and stop laughing at me. And put your retainers in your mouth and leave them in there. I don't want to see them out of your mouth again, do you hear? I have had it.
You!
To hear what I am saying. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
All right. Did I ask you to keep an eye on Mitch and Jason?
I'm sorry, Mom, but I gotta get ready. I got a date.
So have I, dear. I have guests coming, or did you have to?
Yeah, but you don't have to shave, and that takes time. Especially when you got a heavy beard like mine.
Oh, yes. Calico? Enough around here without you. None of your lip. It's a gopher.
Night, Mom. Got a split.
Oh, just a minute, honey.
I know. Drive carefully. Don't be late.
Check.
Check. Hope your party's a gas.
Yeah, thanks a lot. You have fun, too, you hear?
Sexy.
Oh, good.
What those boys need is the firm hand of a man around here. Lord knows you've had your choice with all those fellas your sister brings around. Oh, you know you should do yourself and those boys a favor and get yourself married, PDQ.
Of course, it's not for me to say. You're so right, Holly.
If there's one thing I believe in, it's keeping my place and keeping my mouth shut. Mm-hmm.
It doesn't work. What?
Figures, the boys are playing astronaut with
it. Oh! Look at this wig. It's soaking. I just sprayed the whole thing. Now what do I do? And look at me. Look at this hair, and I have company coming.
Well, couldn't you kind of push it up a little? Do you have a snood?
A what?
Well, you know, a snood. You could kind of put it around here and hold it.
No, I don't have one of those. Will you just stick it in the oven?
The oven?
Yeah, 200. And save some space. I'm going to stick my head in with it.
The oven, indeed. Many more days like this, and you'll be finding me in the oven.
Mom?
What?
How come you didn't show up at my baseball game today?
I couldn't make it, Mitchell. I got busy at the yard, honey. Maybe next Saturday I can come.
Always the same excuse.
Get those washcloths moving. Not fun and games time.
Hey, let me try that.
Until you're rinsed off, you hear me? Didn't I say no fun and games? Now you get back in that tub. Now look what you're doing. You can't work.
Can you please come down here? I need you.
I can't come now, Molly.
Well, we'll just let ourselves in. I guess Abby's busy someplace.
Don't get out of that tub or I'll tear your... Oh! Oh! Oh, oh, hi, Jake.
Hi. I guess we're a little early, huh?
No, I'm a little late.
Well, we met Jake in the driveway. And Jake, how about a drink? Harry can fix you a drink.
Now, Mrs. McClure, about that oven. I've got to put the meat on broil, but your hair's on bake. Now, which will I do first?
I need
need the hair, Molly. I need
false eyelashes, false hair, false bosoms. In my day and age, women were flesh and blood. Nowadays, they're 80% nylon and 20% foam rubber.
Harry, dear, the drinks. Yeah. Jake, a nice drink.
On,
Jake
I'll
never hurt
you.
Anybody.
Matt, I need your help.
Oh, who's that terrible?
Oh.
What must he think now?
Who cares? He's adorable.
You're a mess.
This place has been a wall-to-wall disaster area since I arrived home today.
Well, Abby, you're a great deal of help to me. What am I supposed to say to this man? I would like you to meet my sister, the girl with the golden arm and her hair in the oven.
My hair? Where is my hair?
Well, don't worry about your hair. You aren't even dressed
yet.
What are you going to wear this evening?
I'm wearing this white suit, Maxine. Is that all right with you?
That white suit? Oh, Abby, come on. Why don't you get into that marvelous red geranium hostess
because
thing?
Because it's not that kind of a party, Matt. You know that this is business. You know that all those people in there are customers
well,
from the
lumber. Well, who cares about the lumber
well,
set?
I
you
do,
are
dear.
Dressing
I
for
do.
Him.
I have to be folksy.
Oh, folksy schmoxy, Abby, come on. Get into the red
Maxine,
thing that looks
I swear,
so great.
You are making me so nervous, I don't know what I'm doing. I am not going to wear the red dress.
Nice party, Abby.
Say hello to Mr. Iverson, boys. This is Jason and Mitchell.
Hi, fellas.
Hello.
Hello.
Well, you've met everybody here. Now it's time to go to bed.
You're gonna marry Mommy.
Oh. No, he isn't, dear. Come on.
Boy, Aunt Maxine is sure gonna be disappointed.
You're a chemical engineer.
Yes, that's right.
Where do you do your engineering?
Pacific refineries, mostly.
I just happen to know somebody you should meet. My cousin Dora. She just hasn't been able to find a man her intellectual equal.
Have you tried the Yellow Pages?
Single guys, you got it made. Airline stewardesses.
And nurses.
You're an average fella, huh? You're getting a great girl. Do you know what the worst thing that ever happened to mankind is? The pill.
Helps me sleep nights, though.
Abby is a wonder. You know, I just can't understand why some man hasn't just grabbed her up by now. You know, any man would be lucky to have her for his wife. And I know that there is nothing more in this world that she would desire than to have a loving husband all her own, to love her every night, give her big hugs, keep her cozy, keep her warm, keep her healthy, give her kind words.
This wasn't my house, I'd go home. Oh, Callie.
Nice,
oh,
doggy.
Callie, go
good
stop
boy.
It. I'm sorry.
Oh, it's all right.
Here, use this.
Oh, thank you.
I fixed your drink.
Oh, no, thanks. I've got to go. I better get going. I just got my coat.
Oh, well, I'm sorry you have to leave so early.
Well, so am I, but I got these customers coming in on the 11:30 plane. Oh. And I'll follow with Macron, and I promised them I'd be there.
Oh, I understand. Sure.
Well, we'll have to get together sometime.
That would be fun.
Okay. Well, good night, Abby.
Good night, Jay.
Thanks again for inviting me.
You're welcome. You have my name.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good night.
Bye.
McClure, if you think you have any milk left for breakfast, think again. They finished all the bread, too, and we could use some more butter. And that Mr. Bates spilled all the orange juice. Oh, yes, and tomorrow's my day off, you know.
Okay. I'll go to the market tonight.
Listen, as a surprise, why don't you leave all of this for her till Monday?
Come on. Yeah, we'll be here tomorrow morning at 8 with the camper. Have the kids ready.
Oh, cheerio.
Night, Abby.
Bye. Toodaloo.
You have 48 seconds to get to the airport.
You know what happened? I was just getting ready to leave the house. I was just going out the door and the phone rang and it was the people that I was going to pick up at the airport, you know, on the 11th, I told you. And they called from Accra and they canceled because of, I could have stayed longer, you know, sorry. Oh.
You didn't miss a thing, believe me. Night, Jake.
Night. I really am sorry.
You're sorry you got caught.
Well, it wasn't very nice of me to go running out like that.
No, it wasn't nice, but it was smart.
Okay, will you quit making it easy for me and just let me apologize, huh?
Okay.
Okay, I'm sorry and I apologize.
I accept.
Hey, you gonna get some coffee?
Where?
Well, it's a drive-in.
Oh! Okay.
Okay. Okay. I'll meet you there.
All right.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi, Herbie.
Well, we're just about to close, but for you, tell me what it is you like, and I'll see to it personally. Order anything you want, and I'll charge you for a donut. Hey, what do you think you're doing, buddy? This ain't that kind of chick. This is class. Get back in your own machine.
Oh, let him stay, Herbie. He's kind of nice.
Well, I hope you know what you're doing. But from here on, it's full price for everything.
We have some coffee.
Big spender. Not even a donut?
No, I want her to love me for myself, not the things I can give her.
You blew it. You could have had steak.
Huh. You're not sore, huh?
No, I'm not.
Pretty lousy story about the airport, though.
You would have gotten away with it if I hadn't needed bread.
How long's it been anyway? About 6 years? Seven?
Yeah. I think about seven.
Two coffees, one with cream.
Mine's
sure
cream.
You don't want separate checks? How about a receipt for income tax purposes?
No, it's okay. Thank you.
That's good. Well?
Nothing. I'm just trying to picture you running that lumber yard.
Well, I'm a whiz on a bandsaw, if that interests you.
You run a home, too, and take care of all those kids and everything?
Now, that's difficult. No.
You ever find any time for yourself?
I manage. I have a housekeeper, Mrs. Benson, by name.
Oh, yeah, I met her.
And, it all works.
Well, I think she's trying to tell us something.
It's 2 o'clock. Closing time.
Hey, listen.
Now, don't tell me you were going to apologize again.
No, I wasn't.
Oh, you weren't?
Good night.
Good night, Jake. Thank you. Who is it, Jake? Oh, hi.
Hi.
Well, I couldn't let you carry that heavy bag all by yourself.
Thank you.
Nothing. Well, a while ago I couldn't wait to get out of here. Now you can't get rid of me, you know? Listen, I want to see you again, okay?
Do you? Okay. I'm available.
All right. Tomorrow night too soon?
No.
I'll tell you what we'll do. Go get some spaghetti or something. I'll pick you up about 7.
7?
7:30? 6:30? Hey, now, come on, you guys. Cut it out. I'm trying to read the paper, so let's have a quiet breakfast, huh?
Now, Mom was up late last night. She's probably beat. So settle down, all right? Now, eat.
Good morning, Luke. How you doing?
Hey, hat's off at the table, buddy boy.
Hi.
Mom.
Mom, hi.
Hi, Mommy.
Boy, have we got a day for a picnic. It is gorgeous. Listen, don't forget your graduation rehearsal. Gee, I wish you could go with us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mr. Iverson called.
Oh, he did? What'd he say?
Said it was his kid's birthday or something. Anyway, he won't be able to make it tonight.
It's me. Feel. It's me. Feel. I have known you all my life. Girl, it seems to me that you will always be very close to me, close to me. Very close to me now. Don't need to tell you now. At a time like this, my feelings can't be helped.
Look at the one with the yellow dress.
Oh, that's fabulous.
Aren't you having a good time?
I really am.
Isn't this a great idea?
Yeah, it was, huh? You love it?
Yeah, Harry loves it, don't you, Harry?
Yeah.
Well, Harry and I've been dying for an excuse to come here. Followed you home from the super.
How does it feel to be married to a sex maniac?
Every home should have one.
Why ask him? Ask the mailman.
Well, no, really, it's kind of a shame that Jake didn't come because I think we'd make kind of a handsome foursome.
Yeah, he would like it, I think.
Don't you?
Yeah.
Why shouldn't he go out with a young chick? Why take a bus when you can fly? That you will
always be. Molly, don't forget to have Jason ready at 11:30 for his doctor's appointment.
Oh, Ma, I don't want to go to the doctor.
Why are we going to birthday parties today?
You have to have a checkup to go to camp. And Bobby's present is in on the hall table. It's all wrapped, ready to go. I'm in a hurry.
Hey, boss. Michael said he's got to have all his window frames today.
He'll get it. Will you tell him he'll get them?
All right. Oh, some guy named Iverson called twice. He wants to talk to you. Oh, there's his number.
Thanks. boys, and I mean good night.
San Francisco Bay Area will show signs of precipitation in the AM, followed by clearing and somewhat clearer skies.
Hello?
Hey, you're awful hard to get a hold of. What are you doing, running from the law?
Hello, Jay.
Listen, Flip did tell you about why I couldn't make it last night, didn't he?
Yeah, he said that it was some kind of a birthday or something. It's okay.
Yeah, I forgot all about it. Hey, you want to have lunch tomorrow?
I don't know, Jay. I'm so busy at the yard right now.
Yeah, well, how about some evening then? Friday, okay?
Oh, I don't think so, Jake. It's pretty hectic.
This a brush off? Well, I guess you got your reasons.
Oh, whatever it is, let's leave it at that then. Bye, Abby.
Bye, Jake.
Hi, Mom.
Hi.
Guys.
Oh, you look nice. You look terrific.
Thanks.
Why are you wearing that funny hat?
Because he's graduating.
Do you know your speech?
Did it 14 times to the mirror.
That should do it. I'm a nervous wreck about that speech.
Excuse me just a second, Mom.
Okay.
Hey, Charlie?
Well, I guess maybe, boys.
Hey, come back here.
Now, you know what I told you. If you behave today, you can go with Aunt Max to the lake for the weekend.
Yay.
But if you don't, the deal is off.
Yay!
Flip's going too?
Yay. With you? No, he's not going with you. He's going on his own weekend.
I guess we can go on in now. Come on, guys.
Flip!
Yeah, Mom?
There's a girl standing out there. She's sort of facing us, and she has very long brown hair hanging kind of in front with bangs. Who is she?
That's Stacy Iverson.
Finally made it, huh?
Well, not quite. They haven't given me my diploma yet.
Well, you better go get it before they get wise to you.
Attention, attention, please. Will the graduates and their guests kindly take their seats? The ceremony is about to begin. Thank you.
Busy people.
Listen, I don't know what happened with us, but I think we ought to talk it over. Okay? I brought this stuff along. We could talk it over.
Come in.
How are the kids?
Fine. They're away for the weekend.
How are you?
Fine. Thank you.
Gee, if I'd known it was going to be this easy, I'd have bought the domestic stuff.
I'll get the glasses.
Oh, yeah, I got glasses. Oh. There.
Thought of everything, huh?
Of course. No. Hey, Calico. How are you? Now, you're supposed to eat caviar with this stuff, but I like popcorn better. You like popcorn?
Oh, I love it.
You like
so
it,
does
too?
He.
Okay. Now, then. Champagne Charlie, last of the big spenders.
Okay.
Oh. Hey, you ever gonna tell me why you're so mad at me?
Nope. I had to let you in.
Some coffee?
Oh, it's late. I think I better go, Jake.
Oh, come on. You coming, Stacy? Stacy.
Oh, it feels good in here, huh?
Mm-hmm.
It's cold out.
Okay, I'll get the coffee on in just a minute. You just sit there and take it easy.
Oh, my goodness. It was so good, wasn't it? I ate too much. What are you reading? Teen Scoop. Gossip, huh? Oh, I like that picture of you, Stacy. That's darling. How old are you here?
3.
It's darling.
Pretty frame.
Uh-huh.
Daddy gave it to Mother for their anniversary.
I wonder what time it is. Do you know?
No, but I would think it's kind of late.
Yeah, I think it is.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. Jake,
huh?
I don't think I'll stay and have coffee.
Why not? What's the matter? Oh.
I have such a day tomorrow.
Well, it's still early.
And, coffee. Night, Stacy. I'll see you soon, honey.
Good night, Mrs. McClure.
Here, I'll take you up.
That's okay, Jake. I can manage. Uh-huh. Thank you. Good night.
You sure?
Mm-hmm.
Good night.
How about some of that coffee?
Okay. Oh, hey, I haven't got any cigarettes. I'll just go down the corner and get some. I'll turn that off in about 5 minutes. I'll be right back, honey.
Back again, huh, sweetie?
Hi, Herbie.
Herbie Fleck's too good a thing to pass up. I figured you'd come around to your senses.
Two coffees, please.
Two coffees. I should have guessed Diamond Jim would be here. Diamond Jim, two coffees.
Cigarettes?
Yeah, I'm buying a lot of cigarettes lately.
This is ridiculous.
Hey, I'm sorry about that kid. I think we'll just leave her home next time.
Oh, Jake, we just have to give her time, that's all. She'll get used to me.
Mm.
I think.
Maybe.
I hope.
I did.
Did you?
Yeah, you're pretty nice.
Well, song, pal.
Good night.
It's been very nice, Mr. Ives.
Been grand.
And now, here are some scenes from next week's episode.
Okay.
Don't bother, Mr. Iverson. I'll do it.
Sorry about that.
Well, I guess he's just protecting his domain. You know,
oh,
Stacy does it all the time. That doesn't mean anything.
It's just going to take time.
You know? Excuse me.
Going out, honey?
No, there's a show I want to watch.
Oh. Well, why don't you watch it in your room, then?
I want to watch it in color. Well, guess I better get going.
Hi, Flip.
I'll see you.
All right.
Okay. Listen.
Darn. I forgot Molly's pumpernickel.
Get it in the morning.
Oh, honey, you know how she is. She loves to have pumpernickel with her breakfast. I won't be but a minute.
Don't tell me. I know. Two cups of coffee, right?
Right.
Dame's got to be a masochist.
All right.
Molly.
This has got to be the craziest courtship in history.
Well, I'm sick of this drive-in, I'll tell you that.
Mm. I'm getting kind of sick of Herbie, what's his name?
Fleck.
Fleck! Hey, listen, you want to go for a ride someplace?
I always want to go for a ride someplace.
Do you know what time it is?
What?
It's after 11 o'clock.
You're kidding. Is it really?
Oh. You said you'd be right back.
Oh, I know I did, but it was such a pretty night that I took a drive. We better get to bed. It's late.
Well, you could have called.
Well, I didn't think that you would be up.
I knew I'd be worried, you being out in the car and all.
Honey, I didn't think that you would be sitting up here.
You know what I was getting ready to do? I was getting ready to call the hospital.
Will you please keep your voice down? You'll wake the boys. Now, I want you to calm down, too. I'm sorry if I upset you, but I just didn't think it was necessary to call. Now, let's not make a big case out of nothing, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Night, honey.
Mom.
What?
Where's the pumpernickel? Let's shape up, huh, Mom? Hello, honey.
Hi, Mr. Iverson.
Oh, hi, Janie. I didn't know you were here.
Oh, Janie's spending the night.
Oh, that's good.
Have a good time at Mrs. McClure's.
Yeah, very nice.
Kind of late, though, huh?
Well, I guess it is. Gee. I'll go to bed, then. Good night.
Good night, Mr. Iverson. Are you having an affair with Mrs. McClure?
Do you mean, am I getting serious about her? Is that what you mean?
You're talking like a child. I asked you if you're having an affair.
I heard what you asked me. What the hell kind of question is that, anyhow?
Dad, I'm not a baby anymore. I understand sex. I've known about it for years.
What do you mean you've known about it for years?
No, Daddy, I said I understand it. I didn't say I... Hmm. Are you having an affair?
So Mrs. you be quiet. Well, Janie's out there. What's the matter with you?
Well?
Well, what?
Don't you think you're a little old to be carrying on like this?
Oh.
You could get in trouble, you know.
Hello? Hi.
Hi.
How's it over at your house?
Very hostile.
A little indignant around here.
You know, I forgot the pumpernickel.
Yeah?
Why didn't you remind me?
Because I forgot.
Oh. I miss you.
Yeah. Hey, how old are you anyway?
Why?
Well, never mind. I just know I'm too old for any more of this fooling around. You know what I
mean?
Well,
so am I.
And it's the last time I'm going to meet you in that drive-in. This is really ridiculous, making up excuses about pumpernickel and cigarettes and stuff and coming home and getting a sex lecture from a 17-year-old kid. And I'm fed up with the whole shot.
Well, so am I.
Shut up. I love you. You love me, right?
I love you, right.
Okay.
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Tucked in around here, lady.
Well, you gotta have the numbers there. Ruining those camellias.
Come on, Calico, hurry up. It's 3 o'clock in the morning, boy.
What time's Stacy coming tomorrow?
Oh, she's at Janie's for the night, and I told her to be here about 8 o'clock.
Oh, boy, I can't face it.
Oh, come on now. All we have to do, we just sit them down, we give them some breakfast, and then you tell them. You a right side sleeper, too?
Mm-hmm. Are you?
It's all right.
Oh, Jake.
No, we just got married too quick, that's all. Never mind.
I don't care. Doesn't make any difference. Hey, where are your shoes?
My shoes?
Yes, I want your shoes.
What are you doing?
Never mind. There, that's for my sister.
Your sister?
Right.
Anything else?
She did. It's my day off, you know. Of course, if I'd have known this was going to be your wedding day, I could have rearranged everything, but my plans are made. I'm terribly
sorry. That's all right.
Oh, well, thank you. Yeah. And congratulations again.
Oh, it's so romantic. I mean, eloping to Las Vegas and all that. Oh, I bet you were a beautiful bride.
Oh, dear. I guess I'd better go before I get sloppy.
Have a nice day, Molly. Thank you, Stacy. Thank you for fixing the table so pretty.
That's all right.
Breakfast and everything. What can I help? What can I do for you?
Nothing. I've done everything.
Stace. Honey, I know how you feel. Really, I do. And I know how the boys feel. But you know something? Let me do that.
No, it's okay. I know how Daddy likes it.
Hey, these are pretty good eggs, lady. How'd you know that's the way I like them?
Well, Stacy made them. She did everything.
Oh, well, I always said you're a pretty good cook. Morning.
Morning.
Hi, Rip.
Morning, Mr. Iverson.
Hey, isn't it about time you start calling me Jake?
I sit over here.
Oh, that's your chair?
No, that's all right.
No, well, go on, sit down.
No, no,
that's
all right.
Huh?
No.
He doesn't mind.
Okay.
Oh, boy, this is good. Mr. Iverson, you my daddy now.
Yep. Think you're gonna like that?
I don't know yet.
Hey, listen. I think today calls for some kind of celebration, don't you? Now, what do you say we stay home from work, and then we can all spend the day together somehow?
Let's do. Huh?
Yay! Oh, boy, one big happy family. Yay!
Yay!
Thank you.
take care of our share.
Going home soon, Dad.
Oh, yeah, we were just talking about that, honey. You know, our house is pretty small, and I think, seeing as how there's six of us now, we'd be a lot better off over at Abby's place.
We were gonna be living at her house?
Oh, boy.
Well, you can say that again.
Oh, boy.
What's the matter with that?
Nothing's the matter with that. Only one tiny little thing, like there's no room for me. That's all.
Say that again.
Well, honey, wait a minute. This is just temporary, you know. We can fix up a couch or something for tonight.
Oh, great. Yeah. Excuse me, please.
Oh, Jake. She's absolutely right. She shouldn't have to give up her bedroom.
What do you got in mind?
Well, why don't we all go to your house?
Honey, there's only two bedrooms in my house. Now, that wouldn't be fair to the boys. Where are they going to sleep, on the floor?
You don't have to worry about the boys. They adjust.
Kathy, shut up out there,
It's gonna be a night, I'm telling you. Stop it. I said stop it right now. Oh, well.
Mr. Iverson, you know what?
What?
Our dog hates your dog.
No, they just talk, and when they bark like that, they'll get to like each other all
right. Good night, Cliff. Do you mind turning the radio off, honey?
Night, Cliff.
Left the sink filthy.
Well, there's some cleaning stuff underneath there. You know where it is.
I'm not going to clean up after them.
Well, I'll I'm not going to. No, why should you do it? Nobody has to clean. The boys can do it.
I don't know why I'm doing it.
This is a drag.
Why is?
Can't I cut out and go back to our place and sleep?
This is our house, Flip.
Yeah, but that crummy cot in the kitchen.
What's so bad about sleeping in the kitchen? Well, why can't we have some laughs around here?
Ha!
You know you can grow to hate that word. What is it?
Can I sleep with you?
Out! Get going!
Nothing the matter with that. I was just going to ask you the same thing.
It's very important for Stacy. She's the one who has the big adjustment to make.
What about Flip? It's not so easy for him, you know. He's used to being the man around your house, and now he winds up out in my kitchen on a cot with his radio off.
I know I shouldn't laugh at that. But what else can we do?
Well, I think what we got to do is just sell both of the houses, and then we buy a new one. And we move into that, and it won't be your house, it won't be my house, it'll just be everybody's house, okay?
That's a very good idea. And until we sell, until we sell, we'll alternate between the houses. Go back and forth.
You mean in a different house every night?
Why not? We can manage.
Married a gypsy.
We have to be fair to everybody. Then when Molly is over here, we'll be there. And when she's there, we'll be here.
Yeah.
And that, yes, and then Stacy will have her own bedroom, and that's what I want. She's got to have her own bedroom. Oh.
Can it do anything for you?
It better.
Doing it too.
I'm exhausted.
Mommy.
What's the matter?
I can't find the bathroom.
Hey, Couple of things that I think we ought to hash over. What I started.
There's a couple of things that I.
What's darling? Oh, I love it. Why don't you take that? Oh, come on, Stacy.
Okay.
How much is that, please?
$29.95.
Oh, no, 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 no.
I'll pay for it. I have an account here.
Oh, fine.
Daddy gave it to me.
I know it's been kind of hard for you to get used to the idea of having a father around the house again, but I think that if both of us just...
Thank you. I'm sorry, but I have to go. I promised to meet some friends.
Oh, okay, honey. I'll see you later.
Well, whose house are we going to be at tonight, yours or mine?
Mine.
Hey, come on!
Are they having fun out there?
Oh, I hope so. I don't know.
Listen, when are you two going to stop this traveling circus bit back and forth, huh? Well, what'd you get in Vegas, a marriage license or a driver's license? Well, you haven't even had a honeymoon.
We know that.
Look, why don't you both go up to San Francisco with us for the weekend?
Hey, that's a great idea, huh?
I wish we could.
We can't.
What?
Because the kids, they kill each other, that's why.
Well, now, there is a perfect solution. When you get back, you keep the winners. Hi.
What's going on in there?
Stacy's just having a party. Let's go.
Well, we wanted to watch the basketball game.
In color.
House. Come on, guys.
What did you say about San Francisco?
Oh, am I ready? You know, one thing I don't understand is why parents never run away from home.
Well, we'd love to have you come. Let's go, Max.
Oh, for sure, honey. Well, see you around, fellas. Look,
No, my dear.
Oh, bye-bye. Bye.
Listen, I just told you second marriage would never work out, right?
Get out of here.
Be careful. Mm-hmm.
Hello.
Here I come, right here.
Hey, come on!
Come on, we're going to my house where we can be alone.
Jake. Well, howdy, neighbor.
Hi, Cleo.
Sorry, I haven't been over lately. I've been in Mexico getting a divorce.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm sorry. I thought you were alone, Jake.
No, I'm not. Abby, this is Mrs. Ruskin. She's the neighbor next door. This is Abby, my wife.
Well, I just happened to be walking down the street.
It's a nice night for street walking.
She is your wife, isn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Would you two be living here?
No, I don't think
so.
No, I really don't. No.
Well, have fun, kiddies. You have my number.
Mm. We do.
Well, she used to babysit for Stacy.
Uh-huh.
Besides, her husband is about that big, and he's a tackle for the Green Bay Packers, and I'm scared of him.
Oh,
Mrs. McClure.
Or Iverson.
This is my night to be here, isn't it?
Oh, yes. Mm. Yes, you're right.
This is Mr. Weiss.
Nice meeting you. I already know Mr. Iverson, post office department. Had this roof for 14 years.
Yep.
How do you do?
What happened? What'd you come back for?
Oh, well, Mr. Iverson,
I wanted to see if the for sale sign was still out on the lawn.
It is.
Well, good night. Have a nice time.
Nice meeting you.
Thanks.
And congratulations and good luck on your marriage.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Oh, thank you.
Good night.
Thank you.
Tomorrow's my day off, you know.
Yeah. You know, we're right back where we started, don't you?
Well, I guess so. Even switching houses hasn't helped. Has it?
No, I'm getting very depressed. Yeah, it gives you gas.
Pleasure to serve you. Why don't you come in again sometime when you need empty cups? Why don't you two get married so you'll have a place to go? Why don't they get married so they'll have a place to go?
My house would be perfect, but we need another bedroom.
We haven't got another bedroom.
And that way, Molly would have a bedroom, and Stacy would have a bedroom.
We haven't got another bedroom, honey. I can't just, you know, snap my fingers like that and get you another bedroom.
You just did it.
The camper!
Yay!
Now we're going to use the camper for the extra bedroom till Aunt Maxine gets back from San Francisco. We're all going to quit moving this back and forth stuff, and we'll stay right here in this house.
Yay!
Mother's got a little headache this morning, so.
Yeah.
That's better.
Hey, Mom, can me and Jason sleep in it? The camper!
The camp? No. No. You boys have to sleep in the house. Good morning, everybody. Good morning.
I'll take the camper, Mom.
Oh, fine, Flip. That's good.
But he already has a room. Why can't I sleep in the camper?
We didn't think you'd want to sleep out there, honey.
You take my room.
Oh, thanks a lot. I don't want your room.
Look, it's settled. Forget it, will ya?
But
how many times do I have to argue with this girl? Every time
room.
I come in, I have to ask. I do it.
Please.
Oh, wow, you're so quiet.
Oh, excuse me a minute.
I'll tell you who's going to sleep in the camper. Your mother and I are going to sleep in the camper, and that'll be the end of it.
What? Right?
You and I are going to sleep.
But I thought that you
should be quiet. Be quiet.
Oh, wow.
And you be quiet. You've got a headache, remember? Now, you and I are going to sleep in the camper. That's who's going to sleep in the camper. That is the end of it. Right now, once and for all. And don't hold dinner for me, because I'll be late. Now what did you do? I'm sorry, mood. I'll be home early.
I knew you would be.
I'm sorry. But I can't. We will sleep in the camper, though.
Knock it off! I go out in the back. This is adult talk.
Big man!
Go on. So my room isn't good enough for you, huh?
Nothing about you is good enough for me. This house is so weird.
Do you know what's wrong with you?
What, Mr. McClure?
You're spoiled rotten, Miss Iverson. Excuse me.
Stacy, what are you looking for, dear?
A glass.
Well, they're right in here where they've always been.
Everything's in such dumb places here. At least in our house, you can find something when you want it.
Well, why don't you rearrange the kitchen the way you'd like it, Stacy? Why don't you do that?
Well, I do know what Daddy likes.
Okay, Stacy, you've got your wish. If you want to be the lady of the house, you're gonna be it.
It's Molly's day off, and you can just take charge of everything. We'll start with the ironing. Then we'll do a little mending, a little floor polishing, a little silver polishing. Don't forget to do the bedrooms and clean the bathrooms. Then you'll have to do a little marketing for dinner. And we'll have dinner at 6:30. Have a nice day, Stacy. You want me? I'll be at the hairdresser. You'll have the room in just a shake, honey. How's it going?
Well, here's the list all finished.
Oh, thanks.
Except I didn't know where to put that big silver tray.
Oh, in the living room chest. Oh, what about tomorrow's list? Would you like to work on that?
But tomorrow's Saturday.
Well, I know, honey, but there's an awful lot to do. You're going to have to get an early start. Now, let's see. First, I want you to call your friends and go to the beach for the whole day. And then come home and fix your hair and your nails and make some nice long phone calls and have your dinner and go to the movies. Unless you'd rather be the lady of the house. Stacy. Get some rest, you can use it.
Broke down when I got to the docks. What have you been up to?
See for yourself. Maybe had a breakdown, too.
Where's Abby?
Oh, she's in the bedroom. She just got home.
Laundry, ironing, mending floors for one. She just got home. Where's she been?
I think she was out shopping, getting her hair done, stuff like that.
Her hair done? You mean you did all this by yourself?
I sure did. Been at it since this morning.
Floors to wash.
You know, Dad, it made me realize something.
And would you mind telling me what the hell's going on around here?
What?
This is what I'm talking about. Now, how come you got to lay all the work on Stacy anyway? What's the matter with Flip?
Well, aren't you silly?
What do you mean, silly?
Well,
what's the matter with Flip helping out around here? Why do you have to lay it all on her?
Flip's playing basketball.
Oh, he's playing basketball. That's great. He's
Stop raising your voice to me.
I'll raise
if
my
you
voice.
Shut up long
way
enough,
I can
I'll
get through to you.
You.
And don't tell me to shut up.
Well, I just won't discuss it with you, Jake Iverson.
Well, that's fine. Who wants to discuss it?
If you want to know the truth, it was an experiment.
An experiment?
Yes.
And what, child labor? A 14-hour day?
That is the lowest thing you...
Lowest what?
I was trying to help her.
Help her?
And it'll never happen again, I'll tell you that.
Well, you can be damn sure of that, yes.
You big bully!
What's he so sore about?
Just go to bed, both of you. Me an apology.
I owe you an apology.
You
I owe you an
do.
Apology for what? You happen to owe me an explanation. I still don't know what this is all about.
I don't owe you anything. You're just stupid. If you don't know what I was trying to do for that girl,
don't
then there's no reason for me to even
me
be
stupid.
In here. I didn't call you stupid.
You just called me stupid, and you know something? You're right. I am stupid. We
right.
own two houses, and I'm sleeping in the back of a truck.
And whose idea was that?
All right, it was my idea.
Flip
it was my idea, and
here.
You know why? Yes, so Flip could sleep out here.
Right.
Fine. That was brilliant. That was a brilliant idea. Whose idea was it to get this thing in the first place? Do you remember
Yours.
That?
Yours.
No, you don't remember, because it was down at the drive-in, and you were roaring drunk at the time.
That's a nice thing to say. Why don't you shout it for the neighbors to hear it?
You were roaring drunk at the time!
You're just mean. And you know you're wrong about Stacy.
Of course I'm
you're
wrong.
Dead
I'm
wrong.
A husband. I am your husband. I am married. I've got to be wrong all
you
the
can't
time.
Even
st- wrong.
You can't even say you're sorry.
Oh, I am sorry, all right. I am sorry.
Oh, that's a nice thing to say. What are you sorry about, getting married?
Did I say I was sorry I
no,
got married to you?
No, you're thinking it.
How do you know what I'm
because
thinking?
Because I happen to know what you're thinking every minute.
Oh, you're a mind reader.
And if that's
you're
the way
psychic.
You want it, then it's fine with me.
fine with me.
Go back to that babysitter, whatever her name is.
Cleo. Her name is Cleo.
I'm coming back right now.
Two coffees. They're on Fleck. Again.
Hey. Listen, can you lend me some clothes to wear?
It was that dame, right?
Yeah.
Tore the clothes right off you.
No.
What a tiger.
But some clothes, you got any?
I ain't got no clothes except dirty uniforms.
That's fine, anything.
Dirty uniforms?
Yeah, I don't care.
Hey, I don't mind. It's all right with me, buddy. This is the latest color, chocolate.
No, it's all right.
But I'll tell you one thing. I hope you're not gonna make a regular thing out of this, you
know?
No. This is a hot dog stand, not a haberdashery.
Yeah, I know. Can you give me a lift home, do you think?
No, I'm a bus station. Hey, Duke. Duke, come here. This is, you know, not part of the regular service here, Flex. Come here. Okay. Give this guy a lift, will you?
I got deliveries to make.
So you got another one. Drop him and dump him.
Pardon me. I'm looking for someone. Actually, I'm looking for a man.
Man? How's that again, baby?
Well, I'm looking for my husband. I lost him, and I've got to find him.
What does this cat resemble and look like, baby?
Well, actually, he'd be very easy to recognize because he's in his undershorts, and he's, I think, carrying a teddy bear.
A teddy bear. He took a trip. Went that way.
What did he say?
He went that way.
Thanks very much. Bear.
Saddle up, friend. We shall give thou a hand. That is our bag to help folk. We will follow us.
Gotta find little teddy bear.
Up the birds, then it'd be down to press charges.
Look, Sergeant, I've got to find my husband.
Your royal furs. Let our mother go.
Let our mother go.
Are they with you?
Your fuzziness. My group is Baby's character witness. We are about to commit for you one sit-in until our baby is thoroughly released. Bye-bye.
Yeah.
Down, Cloud, down.
You've got no driver's license, no identification. I think I'd like to talk to this husband myself. Pick him up. Okay, let's have a description. How old is he?
I don't know. Sergeant, the whole thing happened because of the children. They were only happy living in their own home, so we tried moving from place to place, and it didn't work. Then we decided to go to my house. And we thought with the camper, everybody would have enough room, everybody would be happy, and that didn't work either. So then Jake and I had an awful argument, and I said all kinds of nasty things to him, things that I didn't mean. And I said, okay, you can go back to Cleo, and I'll personally take you there myself. And that's what I was doing. I was taking him in when he fell out of the camper.
Yeah, that's fine, that's fine.
You're free, baby. You're free.
You're not going anywhere, sister, but into a cell.
What is this?
You're allowed one call. Use the pay phone, please.
I demand my... I'll take it.
You ain't groovy.
What's going on? Where's your mother?
She's in jail.
She's where?
Police station. She needs identification.
Here, give me that. I'll go.
Mom called me. She doesn't want you. And neither do we. I heard you yelling at her. We had a nice, peaceful family around here till you came along. So why don't you just take her and go back where you came from?
You stay here with them. I'm gonna take the station wagon.
Shut
up, all of you. All right, come on.
Just a misunderstanding, Sergeant. Any further questions, you can contact me in my law firm.
All right, Mr. Scott. The truck driver will be here any minute. You and Mrs. Iverson can work out the damage claims with him. Okay, all settled. Now clear out of here.
Not so too sweet, not sweet. We go when baby goes.
Stacy can't accept me, and the boys can't accept Jake, and that's it.
I'm sorry, mister. I didn't see you were gonna turn.
Sorry!
I'll show you how sorry you're gonna be.
Hey, hold it. Wait a minute, fella. Just take it easy, huh?
Who sent for the good humor, man?
You don't go hitting kids. Now you go on over in the car, see? Go on.
All right. I'll hit him back.
Yeah.
I didn't recognize you without the teddy bear.
Oh, teddy bear!
Wait a minute. You mean to tell me that she is part of this family? This has got to be a plot against the chickens of America. I want to press charges against all of them.
Hold it down! One at a time.
All right, you first.
There was an accident in the parking lot. I don't know whose fault it was.
What parking lot?
When I got there, this ape here was trying to beat up my kid.
And when my dad tried to break it up, he hit him when he wasn't looking.
Self-defense, Sergeant. The whole mob came at us.
Even her. She tried to knock my head off.
The girl was in this, too?
Why not? She's part of the family.
Groovy tribe.
Yeah.
They fight dirty, too. All of them.
Look where the little kid bit me.
It serves you right. You're twice as big as my brother.
And no right to mix in.
He sure did. We're his family. He's our father.
Perhaps this can best be settled in court. Have your attorney call me.
Thanks, Uncle Harry.
Uncle Harry? They even got their own lawyer.
Well, I guess that about settles everything. All right, you can all go.
You guys never stood a chance when you took on that family.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.